Eisenhower for President Headquarters in Washington, D.C., the movement gains impetus as Senator Lodge of Massachusetts announces that Ike's in the New Hampshire primaries. He tells of past political discussions.
During these discussions, he said specifically that his voting record was that of a Republican. He also pointed out that his political convictions coincided with enlightened Republican doctrine and that the family tradition was Republican. It is worth noting that in our conversations with General Eisenhower, he pointed out that he would never seek public office, but would consider a call to political service by the will of the party and the people to be the highest form of duty. I therefore authorize you, Governor Adams, to enter the name of Dwight Eisenhower in the primary election for the expression of the preference of the Republicans of the state of New Hampshire for President of the United States.
At the General's headquarters outside Paris, he confirms Lodge's statement and says he'll accept a clear-cut call. But right now, his first concern is his present job, building Europe's defenses. It is on this task that he now reports.
In this common effort, many advances have been made during the past year. Morale is definitely sturdier among civilians and armed service. In numbers, efficiency, and in spirit, the soldiers, sailors, and airmen of our Allied force have been strengthened.
With the news of Eisenhower's willingness to run, the Washington office from which the drive is directed grows busier as Eisenhower leaflets and buttons go out. Though he may not campaign for nomination, Eisenhower is definitely in the presidential race.